Welcome to Living on the Ocean, epoxy work in the transom of Trimaran Dawn. We extended the transom of Trimaran Dawn on the sandbank and cut a hole in the old transom so we can get to it. Now we can start working with epoxy, carbon fiber, glass fiber and foam to build a strong enough connection to hold this carbon fiber rudder house that we already made. For the new rudder to be fit, we need a new hole in the transom. So we start out with drawing where that's gonna come. And very simple, with PVC foam, some screws and a Stanley knife, we build a shape that's gonna come around the hole to stop the water from coming into the new transom. The rudder in here can turn 35 degrees to port and to starboard, which is much better than the previous rudder that could only do 20. To make a good connection, we need to sand or grind the already existing glass fiber. And for that, we use this one-of-a-kind tool. It's not a normal grinder. The brush moves if you move the handle, and it runs on a very low speed but electronically controls the RPMs. So if you push harder, it doesn't slow down. And it's connected to my vacuum cleaner. So on a low speed, but with power on the blade, I can grind, having the brush in the right position, without seeing any of those white clouds of dust. Just a bit of big pieces, which I will pick up with the vacuum cleaner later. Now that slows down the speed of working a bit. It goes much faster with high RPMs and big white clouds of dust. And if you don't care about cleaning it all up and how clean it stays where you work and live, or where some other people live, or neighbors next to you, yeah, then you can use high RPM grinders. But I'm really against it when good tools like this are on the market. My layers of glass fiber are very thin. And with this tool, if you look well, I can just scratch the surface. Good enough for a good connection. If you look well, it only just takes the shine off and the pencil stripes for where I've been drawing, where I need to grind or where I need to do something. I don't take more away with high speed. You get many times with a grinder those dents in your material. It just went a bit too deep, and you will be in your foam if you work as thin with fiber as I'm doing here. Working like this has kept the fun in it for me for more than 35 years now. After this sanding job, I glue everything together in its right place. And the next day, take all those screws out now. You can see already that a bit of this epoxy on this screw sticks very well. Don't screw them to the bottom because then water comes in, so make sure I'm in reverse. That would be a nice way if you now had a fountain coming out of there. They were tricky to put in for that reason as well. I will take out all the other ones later, but I want to show you something. It just gets boring watching taking screws out. That's going to be the rudder. Now, obviously it's going to be behind here, which I cannot put up perfectly. Because it was actually meant to go farther forwards, it's quite high. And what we're going to do for that is, that's going to be the bottom hinge on the boat. We're going to make that bottom hinge starting here. That means that this part will disappear underwater, and that means that this will be a perfect catch for whatever goes underneath the boat. So we're going to make a little skeg underneath this bit of the boat, that if that's the bottom of the boat, there will be a tiny skeg that just will come up to here and guiding everything towards the blade, which will fold backwards, hinging somewhere there. So I've sanded it all very well. Take away the shine, because it won't stick on shiny epoxy. I've seen many boats I worked on and the layers of fiber just come off so easy with the shine on the underneath, and you know the sanding was on there. So I can now glass fiber over this. The corners are nicely round. Yeah, glass fiber doesn't go around 90 degree corners. I have to put fillers on the inside here. So I have a pair underneath, my sleeves to keep my arms free from epoxy over, and my disposable gloves, which I change quite often. Every time they're sticky. So that's why all those walls are not sticky when I'm working. Because that's so annoying. and bad for your product. So, I've already put some filler material on that foam, but I give it a little bit more epoxy. Already done the inside, but that was hard for me to film. So I'm only gonna give you the outside to watch. Sorry, my pieces of glass, already cut to shape. It's easy to cut off the tops later, which you will see me do. No, I cannot roll into that bottom corner very well. So for that, there's nothing else to do than using a brush. And then you always have to find a place where you can put it, where it ain't making a mess. Next piece. Line out the top, about there. As some people say, it looks so easy if you see somebody do it that has done it for 30 years. It only goes so easy because everything is sanded, they know sharp edges and they know 90 degree corners. This one goes a bit farther down. Oh, I don't want to go over the edge because those fibers will just not go around that corner. Of course, the next layer, if I glue over here, that will be strong enough. Now, this bulkhead will continue towards there and towards there. But this makes a very good connection for this one. And we have enough epoxy, that's good too. And this will not leak anymore. Now what will I do now? People would put on peel ply on here, which is a very good idea if you want to work on it later. It's not really what I do a lot anymore for two reasons. Peel ply is quite costly. And I find it's better, works for me better, to get this surface. And that's in about 2 hours, 3 hours when this epoxy cures, depending upon the temperature and the epoxy hardener you use. I put plaster over it, filler, straight away. So I fill all these tiny holes, any possible air bubbles, I fill them straight away with a filler. And then tomorrow I normally give it a light sand, which I haven't done here. This is just one layer and even this is not sharp. And it's not sanded yet. I only sanded this area to do the job. So for me that works very well. I can sit in here, it's smooth, there's no sharp bits. That was it. Job done. Okay, now this is why I made an opening. Don't touch anything. I learned very well how to walk on my elbows. I'm in my work bit. Without touching anything, using bits of cardboard. If I want to keep things dry, there's a little bit of epoxy left. Always happens, just leave it to cure. Yeah. This brush is trash, so it goes with the curing stuff. And this is trash as well. Now I need some acetone. Acetone will eat my gloves a bit, but not the black gloves that I have underneath. I can cure. You'll see my white gloves disappearing now, but they cannot handle the acetone. And one thing that I miss in many shops to get
to make very nice round corners. We call it the plastering rubber. I don't know how you call this. That's actually, if I translate, the Dutch plamuur rubbertje. Yeah, that can go in there. Nice thing from this is, it's very nicely can go into corners to plaster with. That's what's left of your gloves after you touched acetone.
We hope you enjoyed this episode of Living on the Ocean, epoxy work in the transom. And we're having places available on Trimaran Dawn for people that want to come over for a period of time to be part of the adventures, to sail with us on the ocean and to build with us on Trimaran Dawn. You can click the subscribe button to follow our adventures.
And dry again, clean. I can touch my face, I can touch everything.
See you next time.